Good afternoon, YouTube. So this is my Takagi condensing tankless water heater, and I've got it set right now so the outlet or hot water temperature is 140 Fahrenheit, which is as high as it goes. Currently, I'm in the middle of a dishwasher run, and the heater just finished running, filling the dishwasher for a rinse cycle. And one thing I've just done the other day is I added a thermometer here. This is an indoor-outdoor thermometer. Right now it's about 70 Fahrenheit. That's the indoor temperature. And it's about the same outside. It's kind of a smoky, overcast day, so it's really not getting very warm. But I have this external temperature probe is mounted up in the exhaust stack. It's actually at the very top of the exhaust pipe on the roof. And then I just drop that beside the 3-inch PVC venting and ran it down to this thermometer here. So you'll notice the displayed outside temperature is warmer than this 70 Fahrenheit. It's 81. I'll turn on the hot water here in the utility sink. So there's our incoming water temperature. It's summer here, so we get pretty warm water, 74 Fahrenheit. And like I say, I'm going up to 140, so this should be 140 right here pretty soon. It'll come back there, it's coming back down. And then if we look at the gallons per minute, 1.3. And what you'll notice is this outside temperature has started to go up. So it was sitting around 80, 81 degrees, and it's gone up now 10 degrees. And we'll let this run for a while. The thermometer doesn't update really fast. There we are, 95. And right now with the temperature rise and this flow rate, the heater is using about 40,000 BTUs per hour. That's about 12 kilowatts. And you can see the temperature now, it's going up slower. And what I find is it gets up around 100 Fahrenheit, and that's as hot as the exhaust temperature gets. Yeah, now the dishwasher just kicked on, so now we're running about 80,000 BTUs. So we've about doubled the output. So this will be good. We can see what the temperature goes up to. It's right at 100 now, 2.7, so the dishwasher's still running. Oh, there we jumped up a bit, 104 roughly. So that's 40 Celsius. And like I said, we're running, well, now the dishwasher just shut off. We were running about 80,000 or 24 kilowatts. Now we're down to about 40,000 or roughly 12 kilowatts. And yeah, we hit maybe just short of 108, because now it'll probably start coming down, I bet. Yeah, see, now it's dropped. It might have gone up to 110 Fahrenheit. It's definitely dropping. It's 106. It'll probably even go down from here. Running at 40,000 BTUs runs around 100 Fahrenheit, maybe a little bit below 40 C. Up at 80,000 BTUs, it might hit 110 Fahrenheit if you let it run long enough. And this heater is rated at 120,000. So that was running either one-third or two-third of the maximum output. Now the important thing is this PVC venting is rated for up to 140 Fahrenheit. So the manufacturer, Takagi, does specify that you can use PVC venting. In fact, they supply PVC adapters with this tankless heater. And the reason they can do that is because this is a condensing heater. There's actually two heat exchangers inside the unit. The main heat exchanger has the gas burner under it and is heating the water to go out the hot water side. But there's a secondary heat exchanger that's taking the exhaust gas that's going up the exhaust pipe. It's taking that hot exhaust gas and it's running the cold water through that heat exchanger and condensing the water vapor out of the exhaust gas, recovering about another 10% energy and reducing the exhaust gas temperatures, keeping the exhaust gas below the 140 Fahrenheit operating temperature on the solid core PVC venting. Now, if you have a non-condensing heater, the hot exhaust gas going up the flue is probably well over the boiling point of water. And that's why you have to use a metallic flue. It's got to be corrosion resistant, because that hot exhaust can condense and it's mildly acidic. So between the two of those, you need something like stainless steel, which is much more expensive than the solid core PVC venting. I just wanted to show you that the temperature on the exhaust stack does not exceed the 140 Fahrenheit. In fact, they have a temperature sensor inside the unit that monitors the exhaust gas temperature. And if it gets close to that 140 Fahrenheit maximum, it will shut the heater down on a high limit. So that's one of the misconceptions I've found that people have with tankless heaters. They assume that one tankless heater is pretty much like another tankless heater. So for example, someone might have a non-condensing Takagi heater in their house, and their heater has stainless steel venting, and they assume that all tankless heaters must have stainless steel venting. But there's two factors that influence that. One is, if you have a condensing heater, you can get by with PVC venting because the condensing heater keeps the temperature in the exhaust below the temperature rating of the PVC material. But there are some localities, like New York City, I believe, doesn't allow PVC venting no matter what. You have to use metallic venting. Yeah, so you definitely need to use the solid core PVC. You can see this is solid core. It's not cellular core drain pipe. Yeah, you can probably see a few little water droplets on the side of the condensate line, and it was pulling water vapor out of the exhaust, and that's how it gets the extra efficiency. So for example, this heater is rated at 93% efficiency as a condensing unit. If it were non-condensing, it would probably be around 80% efficient. So it's not just an accident that you can use PVC venting. You know, the manufacturer had to design in features to make sure that PVC venting is acceptable. They had to choose that as a goal to be able to use PVC venting, and then they had to add features into the heater to make sure that they didn't go above the temperature rating of that material, and they had to design that, test that. You can see on the thermometer it works. It does what it's supposed to do. So yeah, if you have any other questions about that, go ahead and post up in the comment section below, and I'll put some other videos over here on the left-hand side you might be interested in. And as always, thanks for watching.